A classic physics problem states that if a projectile is shot vertically up into the air with an initial velocity of 153 feet per second from an initial height of 121 feet off the ground, then the height of the projectile, h, in feet, t seconds after it's shot, is given by the equation h equals negative 16 t squared plus 153 t plus 121. Find the two points in time when the object is 170 feet above the ground, round to two decimal places. Let's first take a look at this graphically. I graph the equation in Desmos. Notice I use y instead of h on the left side, and I'll explain why in just a moment. Notice we have a graph of a quadratic function that opens down, and we're trying to find the time at which the projectile reaches 170 feet above the ground. We can see there's going to be one point in time on the way up, another point in time on the way down. When I had the equation as h equals, I tried to graph h equals 170, and I wouldn't graph in Desmos, which is why I changed the h to y. If I graph y equals 170, we can see graphically we're looking for the t-coordinate of this point on the way up and the t-coordinate of this point on the way down. Let's first solve this algebraically, and then we'll come back and verify this graphically. So again, to answer the question, we want to solve h equals 170, which indicates we substitute 170 for h in the equation. Next, we want to set the equation equal to 0 by subtracting 170 on both sides. 121 minus 170 gives us negative 49, shown here on the right. So we now want to solve the equation 0 equals negative 16 t squared plus 153 t minus 49 for t. This is not factorable, so we'll have to use the quadratic formula shown below, where, of course, instead of x equals, in our case, we'll have t equals. Looking at the equation, notice that a is negative 16, b is 153, and c is negative 49. And now we perform substitution into the quadratic formula, where we have t equals negative b is negative 153, plus or minus the square root of, under the square root we have b squared, which is the square of 153, minus 4ac, which is minus 4 times negative 16 times negative 49, and the denominator is 2 times a, which is 2 times negative 16. And now we simplify, which gives us t equals negative 153 plus or minus the square root of 20,273, all divided by negative 32. Because of the plus or minus, we actually have two solutions for t, which is what we expect. Again, one time when the projectile is on the way up, and one time when the projectile is on the way down, it will reach a height of 170 feet above the ground. So one solution, we'll call t sub 1, is equal to negative 153 plus the square root of 20,273, all divided by negative 32, which comes out to approximately 0.33 seconds. And then for the second time, we have t sub 2 equals negative 153 minus the square root of 20,273, all divided by negative 32, which gives us approximately 9.23 seconds. Which indicates the projectile will be at a height of 170 feet at approximately 0.33 seconds on the way up, and at approximately 9.23 seconds on the way down. Again, before we go, let's verify this graphically. We can easily check our answers by clicking on the points of intersection of the height function in the horizontal line where we have the height equals 170. Again, we have two points, one here on the left, and more on the right. Notice for both ordered pairs, the second value of the ordered pair, or the height, is 170 feet, and the first value of the ordered pairs are the times of approximately 0.33 seconds and 9.23 seconds. Notice Desmos makes it very easy to find the coordinates of points of intersection. I hope you found this helpful.